Hello everyone, this is Agosh P. Prasad. So recently I've been working on some projects that required me to shoot smartphones from the top down, that is the camera is facing the smartphone from above downwards, and that requires a overhead camera mounting system and I don't have it. And if you search online for DIY camera mounting mechanisms, like, you will find a lot of them. But the thing is that most of these setups relies heavily on the use of a bottom plate. A bottom plate is this particular thing that we attach to the bottom of a camera. The bottom plate makes it easier for the camera to be mounted onto a tripod or a gimbal, etc. Almost all these DIY overhead mounting setups that we see online uses this particular bottom plate in order to mount the camera onto the frame of the setups. But I don't have this bottom plate, and it's quarantined right now, COVID-19 quarantine, and I am living in a rural area, so ordering this thing online is not an option. So that got me thinking, how can I solve this problem with the stuff that I already have in my home? So I thought for a moment and went to my attic, and there I found this old chair which was literally older than me. It did not have a seat, so that will make my work easier. So I just brought it down and give it a good rub because it was very dusty. While I was at it, my dad checked the storage and found a suitable piece of wood. This step is very crucial because the piece of wood should be able to hold the camera, but on the other hand, it should not be too heavy also. Like, it should be light enough so that it can be easily moved, as well as it should be able to hold the weight. So once we took the measurements, we cut it. We took more measurements and cut again.
Perfect.
The nails are first hammered into one of the wooden pieces so that it will be easier to hammer it into the next wooden piece. And after hammering in just 4 nails, we have something like this. Since the piece of wood we used was not smooth enough, we decided to sand it down so that the camera can slide over it much easily.
Smooth.
After that, we are basically done. It was time for testing. After assembling everything and putting the camera on, it was amazing. I can move the camera horizontally as well as vertically, flawlessly and smoothly, even quite smoothly. Like, if I sand it more, I can make it much smoother, and practically we can get up to 25 cm horizontal and 25 cm vertical movement. All the camera keys are accessible. We can change the zoom, we can change the focus, the aperture, the shutter speed. All the physical buttons are accessible. Since everything was working fine, it was just the matter of setting it up on my table and taking a shot. Positioning the shot was easy peasy lemon squeezy, and everything went well. The credits goes to my dad because he's the brains behind this project. Shopping online and buying stuff right now in this corona quarantine period is not at all feasible, especially if you are someone like me who is living in a rural area. So I strongly suggest that you also look around your house, and there will be something there that you can use for your needs that will solve your problem, just like I did today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please hit that like button if you liked it and subscribe. I'll be posting more videos in the future. Meanwhile, just stay healthy and take care.